In the previous video, I shared how you can use the Google Maps Platform Combine framework to use reactive programming concepts with Combine to build responsive maps. If you haven't seen it yet, I recommend watching that first for a short intro on Combine and how you can use it with maps. If you're also using the Places SDK for iOS, the Google Maps Platform Combine framework also contains publisher extensions so you can receive responses through Combine. To get started using Places with Combine, install the Google Maps Platform Combine framework using Swift Package Manager or CocoaPods. If you are using Swift Package Manager, you'll also have to install the Places SDK for iOS using one of the available installation options. Once installed, the Google Maps Platform Combine framework provides extensions on GMS Places client that return future objects, which is a type of publisher that only emits a single item. So instead of using the original callback-based API, you can call the overloaded extension function to receive a future instead. For example, when fetching details for a place, you can use the fetch place overloaded method that returns a future to receive more info about the place. To kick off this request, just like any publisher, you would call sync to subscribe to and provide a block, which will be executed when the place is received. While subscribing to the future object is the simplest use case, you can compose a future object with other combined constructs, like merging it with another publisher stream or returning it as a result of an operator. If you'd like to dive into the code, check out the GitHub page for this framework linked in the description of this video to learn more. There's also an example app that comes with it to help you get started. If you're new to using the Places SDK for iOS, make sure to check out the videos I linked in the description. Like this video if you found it useful, and make sure to subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.